So you're taking a stats class and you've gone over too many different hypothesis tests to count. A big question on your mind might be which hypothesis test to use and what does the alternative hypothesis look like? In this video, I will be demonstrating how asking yourself a few short questions can help you find the right hypothesis test. Let's start with the most important question. What are we testing? There's three options in what we are testing: the variance, the proportion, or the mean. The question might be worded, if you want to determine whether the variance is different, if you want to determine whether the proportion is higher, if you want to determine whether the mean is lower, or any combination of it. Now, if the question is asking if something is higher, that's a one-tail test. If it's asking if it's different or unequal to, that's a two-tail test. And if it's asking if it's lower, it's also a one-tail test. So let's go over the first step in figuring out which hypothesis test to use. Are we talking about the variance, the proportion, or the mean? The question will say it. Let's start with the proportion. Let's say a question gives you some percentages on the amount of Canadians that play hockey. Well, if they had one sample to go off of, we would use the Z-test 1P. The Z-test is used usually when you know the population standard deviation, or if it's a proportion question. All proportion questions use the Z-test. Let's look at our example here. Do more than 30% of Canadians play hockey? Well, the alternative hypothesis for this would be population proportion greater than 0.3, do more than 30%. Do 30% of Canadians play hockey? If that's what the question's asking, then we're looking at a two-tail test. Population proportion does not equal 0.3. Or does less than 30% of Canadians play hockey? Population proportion less than 0.3. Now let's say we have two samples. Okay. We have a sample of Netflix, Canadians that have Netflix, and Canadians that have Disney Plus. For our question, it might be asking, do a greater percentage of Canadians have Netflix over Disney Plus? Well, our alternative hypothesis would be proportion, population proportion one, and I stated that Netflix is sample one. So Netflix greater than population proportion two, Disney Plus. Do a greater percentage of Canadians have Netflix over Disney Plus? Do the same percentage of Canadians have Netflix as Disney Plus? Well, that would be population proportion one does not equal population proportion two. And finally, does a lower percentage of Canadians have Netflix over Disney Plus? Population one is less than population proportion two. So that goes over the two proportion types of hypothesis tests there are. Next, we'll do the mean, which is the most common hypothesis test. We're going to do mean and we're going to go to one sample. The question only gives you information for one sample. Now, the next question we should ask is, do we know the population standard deviation? If we do know the population standard deviation, we use the Z-test, one sample. And if we don't know the population standard deviation, we're only given the sample standard deviation, we use the T-test. That's usually how it is. So I have some example questions here. Is the mean price of the new iPhone greater than $2,000? Well, the alternative hypothesis would be population mean greater than $2,000. Is the mean price of the new iPhone $2,000? Well, the alternative hypothesis would be population mean does not equal 2,000. And finally, is the mean price of the new iPhone less than $2,000? Well, population mean less than 2,000. Notice it's the same alternative hypothesis for both the Z and T test, because whether you know the population standard deviation or not does not really change the hypothesis test. The alternative hypothesis. So after one sample mean, we're going to move on to two sample mean. So two sample mean splits up into three categories. We have categorical data, or you know the population standard deviation. We have independent data, so both samples are not matched or paired. And then we have matched and paired. And I'll get into that in a bit. So categorical data, you're going to know the population standard deviation. You're going to use the z-test two sample. It's a two sample test for the mean. And you know the you have to input the population standard deviation. Next, we have two sample independent, right? And then that also breaks into equal variance and unequal variance. So the question might tell you, oh, they have an assume an equal variance or assume an unequal variance. You would know which path to go down. Or if it doesn't tell you, well, one of our tests is a test for the variance. Let's look at the variance test. So a question might ask you, oh, test the variance is the determine whether the variance is higher than is the variance of the mean wait time of pizza greater than the variance of the mean wait time of Domino's. That's a variance hypothesis test. That's not related to a two sample mean test. But if they give you a two sample mean test and they don't tell you the variance is the same or is equal or unequal, well, you can run this variance test. It's called an F test. There's only one. And we can determine whether the variances are equal or unequal, like this second type alternative hypothesis here. Is the variance of the mean wait time of pizza different than the variance of the mean wait time of Domino's? The alternative hypothesis is variance one, so pizza does not equal variance two, which is Domino's. Or it could be for your question to determine whether we use a t-test pooled on or a t-test two sample pooled off. If it's an equal variance, pooled on. Unequal variance, pooled off. And here are some example alternative hypothesis. So a question might ask, is the mean height in Canada, sample one, higher than the mean height in America, sample two? Well, the alternative hypothesis would be mean one greater than mean two. Is the mean height in Canada different from the mean height in America? Mean height or mean one does not equal mean two. And then finally, is the mean height in Canada lower than the mean height in America? Mean one less than mean two. That's the alternative hypothesis for those two. Now, our final type of hypothesis test is a matched and paired slash paired. Now, what you do here is you take the both samples and you subtract one from the other, like it looks like in our hypothesis, in our alternative hypothesis. And that gives you a single list of numbers. You'd put that in your Casio calculator, perhaps. And we do a t-test one sample. So let's say that we were trying to compare the price of delivery on Uber Eats and Skip the Dishes from the same restaurants. Since they're the same restaurants, it would be paired. You know, it would be one from Uber Eats, one from Skip the Dishes. And maybe since Uber Eats is sample one, we have the price say, of Uber Eats minus the price of Skip the Dishes, right? So if a question asks, is the mean price of delivery on Uber Eats higher than the price on Skip the Dishes from the same restaurants? Well, if Uber Eats is sample one, if sample one is a higher number than sample two, since sample two is subtracting from one, if one is higher, it will be greater than zero. So H1, the alternative hypothesis, is going to be mean one minus mean two greater than zero. Next up, is there a difference between the mean price of delivery on Uber Eats and Skip the Dishes from the same restaurants? So if they were the same, if both mean one and mean two were the same number, it would equal zero. So if we're testing whether they're not equal to zero, mean one, the alternative hypothesis would be mean one minus mean two does not equal zero. Finally, our example for the lower then is the mean price of delivery on Uber Eats lower than the price on Skip the Dishes from the same restaurants? Well, if Uber Eats was the cheaper price, let's say two, and Skip the Dishes was three, two minus three would be less than zero. We're testing whether it is less than zero. And that would be the alternative hypothesis there. As you can see, it's not too bad once you figure out that there are only three things that we could be testing: variance, proportion, mean. Variance, we already know it's an F-test, so that's very easy. And then once you get to mean and proportion, we just see how many samples there are, one or two. Do we know the population standard deviation? That determines whether it's a Z or a T test. Do we know the population standard deviation again, or is it categorical data? That's also another Z test, two sample. Are the samples independent, or are they matched paired, like in our Uber Eats example? And then finally, do they have equal variance or unequal variance? That determines whether you use pooled on or pooled off. And you can always test that with the F test up here. Hopefully this video tells you how to figure out which hypothesis test to use and what the alternative hypothesis must look like. Thank you.